What's up, guys, and welcome to PC Wars episode 2, where you submit your desk setup. What the hell? What's up, guys, it's Ed back again from TechSource, and welcome to PC Wars episode 2, where you submit your custom PC to get featured on the channel and a chance to win $100. If you guys are new to the series and want to submit your custom PC, make sure to watch the video linked down below. So with all that said, let the PC Wars begin. This video is brought to you by G2A, where you can buy super cheap CD keys for any game on any platform. This is where I get all my games from, as well as Windows keys for my monthly PC builds, but I'll leave a link down below so you can see for yourself. As always, all the parts in these PC builds will be linked down below for anyone that is interested, but here are your 5 contestants for this week. Deohan, Elvin, Faisal, Jeff, and Josh. Congrats for making it into PC Wars episode 2. Deohan is first up with his NZXT build, and look how handsome that face is. Just look at it. No, but seriously, I do miss my H440 case, and it has served me well. And it's just a phenomenal case, and I will never get tired of seeing it. So in this bad boy, we have an i7-4790K processor, an MSI GTX 980, and 16GB of Corsair Vengeance RAM clocked at 2400MHz. We also have the H100i from Corsair to keep things cool. Now for benchmarks, it scored an 11,682, which isn't bad considering it only has a single graphics card. On the other hand, cable management is not that bad. However, I'm not really a fan of the stock PSU cables, but it is what it is. Next up is Elvin with his custom designed PC. All the parts are carbon fiber vinyl, which are hand-cutted by himself, so plus one for the awesome craftsmanship, my dude. I absolutely love the black and red strips on the top and the ROG and GeForce logos you have on the side of your case. You should honestly start your own business and sell these, because I would buy them in a heartbeat. So aesthetics aside, the PC is running on a 4790K processor, which is overclocked to 4.6 GHz and has a GTX 970 graphics card, 16GB of Vengeance Pro RAM at 1866MHz, and an H100 GTX to keep things cool. So apparently the custom work doesn't stop there. We have a custom cover for the PSU, GPU, and even the RAM sticks. Job well done indeed. I also noticed the two painted PCIe brackets near the back, and let's go ahead and take a look at the benchmarks. So got a modest score of 10,311, which isn't bad. Honestly, I love what you did with the PC. This is a unique build, but if you took the extra steps to do all that custom work, I would definitely replace those stock PSU cables. That's basically the only thing you are missing from turning your PC into one sexy monster. Next up, we have Faisal from Setup Wars episode 16, which he ended up winning an ultra-wide monitor for, so congrats on that, man. So we have another custom designed PC. All of the red covers here have been handcrafted from acrylic, including the PSU cover, the GPU backplate, and even the custom-made hard drive cage up top with the Corsair logo. Honestly, brilliant work. The PC itself has an i5-4440 CPU, an MSI R9-280 graphics card, 16GB of Vengeance RAM at 1600MHz, and an H100i CPU cooler. For benchmarks, it managed to score a 7052, which is expected from an i5. I don't know what's going on with those twisted cables from the GPU, but everything else looks awesome, and you have a pretty sick black and red PC. Jeff is next up with his Air 540 build. So we have a 4790K CPU paired with two GTX 970 Superclock Edition graphics cards, along with 16GB of Dominator Platinum RAM, and an H55 CPU cooler. For benchmarks, it scored a 15,425, which puts this PC at the number one spot for the most powerful PC so far in this episode. Loving the custom cables from CableMod and the custom painted grills on the case. Very clean build, and the cable management is spot on. Honestly, I don't have any complaints. Last but not least, we have Josh with our very first water-cooled build. We have a 4770K overclocked to 4.0GHz paired with an EVGA GTX 780 Ti and 2A SLI. We also have 16GB of Vengeance RAM and water cooling parts from EK. For benchmarks, it scored a whopping 17,433, which ends up taking the lead and claiming the top PC performance spot for this episode. It's a great build, but I think it's lacking sophistication and design. The tubes don't have a unique pattern and they are just connecting to the blocks more by convenience than aesthetics. I really think that the potential of this build is being shadowed by not only the stock PSU cables, but the case itself. Nonetheless, it's our very first water-cooled PC, and it's a very clean build at that. Thank you, Josh, for entering. So that's it for this week's episode of PC Wars. Voting begins now, so make sure you guys drop a comment down below and vote on who has the best custom PC. As always, voting will end this Saturday, and I'll announce the winner on Sunday on my Twitter and Instagram accounts, so make sure you guys are following me there if you want to know who wins. If you guys enjoy PC Wars and want me to continue doing these once a month, then make sure to hit that like button to show your support. But once again, thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video.